Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to start with the daily RBI series, and today is the day of day 16. Today is the day date of day 16 for government schemes. So I'm going to cover five questions from the area of government schemes, which are going to be very useful for the upcoming RBI MCB examinations. And these quizzes are acting as a revision for your upcoming exam. So do take these quizzes regularly along with me, and also after I'm done with these quizzes, you can go to the website, take these quizzes. This will ensure that you are in the right track with respect to revising regularly, okay? The quiz for today starts with one particular scheme from National Rural Drinking Water Program. So National Rural Drinking Water Program was launched in the year 2009 and it was restructured in 2017. The question is, what percentage of the total fund will be allocated to Japanese encephalitis or acute encephalitis syndrome affected areas, which has been changed recently? So this is an amendment and therefore holds a lot of importance for the upcoming exam, okay? The answer to this question is A, 2%. So 2% of total funds will be earmarked for Japanese encephalitis, which I believe still is not enough because it's a major issue in states like UP and Bihar, especially Bihar, and every year we have a lot of deaths. Japanese encephalitis, to clarify, is a result of a mosquito bite. So it spreads because of mosquitoes in certain parts of the country which are affected by Japanese encephalitis specific mosquito. And as I said, launched in 2009, which ministry? Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. So the past 2 days, we've been covering a lot of schemes from Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation only. I think this will help you revise the entire Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation, which holds a lot of importance for the examination. Okay. A lot of more, coverages or information related to National Rural Drinking Water Program through second question. The question is, NDRWP is a centrally sponsored scheme aimed at creation of rural drinking water infrastructure in the country. What are the two union territories covered in the program? So all 29 states and two UTs are covered in this program. What are the names of these two UTs? Andaman and Nicobar and Pondicherry or Puducherry. These are the two UTs which are covered in this program. What is the purpose of National Rural Drinking Water Program? To ensure that every person in rural area is getting safe water for drinking, cooking and other various purposes. Okay, this is the main purpose. Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, very important scheme, has been asked in the past also. So this question specially is a previous question. This was asked, I believe, in the year 2017 or 2018 in NABARD as well as in RBI. Both of them had this question. The question is, Fasal Bima Yojana was launched to provide insurance coverage and financial support to farmers. What is the uniform premium for Kharif, Rabi and horticulture? Kharif, Rabi and horticulture. If you know the answer, I believe you should. Very easy question. Please write it in the comment section below. The answer is 2% for Kharif, 1.5 for Rabi, and for horticulture it is 5%. So the answer is A, 2%, 1.5% and 5%. Now Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana was launched in the year 2016 under Ministry of Agriculture and modified in 2018 because of certain reasons for its failure. It is mandatory for bank loanee farmers. This is something that nobody is going to tell you. It is mandatory for bank loanee farmers and optional for non-loanee farmers. Okay, so if you've not taken a loan and you are a farmer, this is optional, but it's mandatory if you are a farmer and you've taken a loan from the bank. Another question from Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana was launched to provide insurance coverage and financial support to farmers, but it could not achieve its targets, as I said in the previous question. Which one of the following is not a reason for its failure? So what are the reasons for failure? Delay in claim settlements, yes, it's a reason for failure. Inadequate unit of insurance, yes, it's a reason for failure. They could not identify an adequate unit of insurance, and low financial awareness is also a reason for failure. Okay, but which one of the following is not a reason for its failure? B is the answer, different crop insurance scheme for all states. The actual reason for failure is that they had a standard crop insurance scheme for all states, which means that if a state, let's say Bihar, is getting insurance on a certain basis and they're providing premium on a certain basis, a state like, let's say, Goa, or a state like, let's say, Andhra Pradesh is also providing the same standards, which is incorrect because every state has a specific reason for failing for when it comes to Fasal Bima Yojana, when it comes to farmers distress. The answer has been given here as wrong, but I will be correcting that. The answer is B only in this case. Okay, let's come to the last question for today. The question says, which the aim of conservation and development of indigenous breeds, Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying launched the Rashtriya Gokul Mission. Rashtriya Gokul Mission. What is the primary objective of Rashtriya Gokul Mission? Bovine breeding as well as bovine productivity. The purpose is to increase productivity of cattle in India and also to breed indigenous varieties because they are better for Indian conditions, okay? Instead of following and importing the foreign varieties of cattle, we should be focusing on Indian varieties by inbreeding them and increasing their productivity through genetic transformation. What are the two components of the scheme? National Program for Bovine Breeding, as I mentioned, yes. National Mission on Bovine Productivity, yes. These are the two major elements or components of the scheme. So the answer is 1A, 1 and 2. Okay, these are the two major components of the scheme. One important question from you that I want to ask you: what is the allocation? What is the allocation under Rashtriya Gokul Mission for the year 2019-20, which has been made in the budget this time? So provide me the answer below in the comment section. I have already mentioned the answer in the explanation of this quiz, so you can get the answer there as well. I'm not showing it to you here. I want you to search for it and if possible take this quiz again and provide me the allocation amount as mentioned in the budget in 2019-20 for Rashtriya Gokul Mission. Okay, I hope you like this video. If you did, if you learned something new, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon as well, and make sure that you are there every day in order to take these quizzes for your fast and effective revision for the upcoming RBI and SEBI examinations. Okay, all the very best. Take care. Have a nice day.